Hello, good evening and welcome to Reprieve Media CIC. We're lucky today. We've got another charity fundraiser that's happening. I think it's happening on this May bank holiday. We've interviewed the gentleman before, a man by the name of Daniel Selcraig. We mentioned in that interview that we were going to try and nail him down for an interview before jump, just so we can assess his nerves, really, because we like the guy. We don't want him to do anything he might regret. So we're just gonna try and ascertain his state of mind and mood at the time, and give him another time to plug the event quickly. So on with the miracles of technology, on the other end of this Skype line at the moment should be Daniel Selcraig. Daniel, are you there, sir?
Yes. Good evening, Paul.
Fantastic news. Yes, there he is. Brilliant. Good to see the technology working in our favour. Daniel, how are you, sir? Since we last spoke.
Yeah, good. Thank you. How are you keeping?
Busy, it's all going on. I'm still not quite as famous as you though, mate. But wasn't say, but we'll touch on that a bit later. Firstly, why you're here is the charity fundraiser that you're doing. Am I right in saying it is this Bank Holiday Monday?
Yeah, it's 7 days away, believe it or not.
7 days. Craig David will be writing a song as we speak.
Yeah.
I think he will, actually. Or a more accurate phrase would be someone will be writing a song for Craig David, I think. Right. So basically, if you could just quickly tell us about the event. Daniel, what inspired you to do the event, first of all?
So it seems an absolute age ago now, but it was Christmas. I heard that Blue Rider up at Fort Paul had a donation tin stolen by someone. They walked into reception and pretty much just robbed it, and they lost quite a bit of money from it. I reflected on it and decided to raise some money for them and thought of a charity skydive.
So the event has been in the pipeline for quite a while. When did you think of the idea? Just in the new year then, just around that time?
Yeah, it was just coming up to the start of January. I can't even remember how I thought of doing it. It just literally popped up in my head and thought, well, why not?
And regarding the event itself, I mean, how have you found it? I mean, you're quite an experienced fundraiser, are you not?
Yeah, I've done quite a few other fundraising products, fundraising ideas. And when I was at college, we raised a lot of money for Help for Heroes. But no, this is a completely different challenge. Obviously, it's something that's in the future. So trying to get money out of people for something you've not yet done is a little bit trickier than I thought, but I've absolutely smashed my target. I aim to raise between 1,000 and 1,500, and I'm now well over the £2,300 mark, which is just unbelievable.
That's because you're famous, mate, now. Did you not know?
I've heard a few stories, but I wouldn't say famous.
They're all true, mate. Trust me. If half of them are true, then that's remarkable. But I think in this case, all of them are true. But so we're going to touch on that, like I said, a bit later. And the event, obviously, you said you were really impressed with the generosity of the Peterborough public. I'm assuming it's all just around Peterborough, but maybe not. What support have you had in organising the event so far?
It's been brilliant. All my friends and family have all been behind me, offering me support and guidance. Local media has been really helpful as well. I've had a news on BBC Radio Cambridgeshire, the local Peterborough magazine, the ESP magazine. A big thank you to Mark Hernandez, who wrote a brilliant article about it. Just gave me a bit of publicity, which helped me raise a little bit more money. But yeah, everyone's just tried to see what I've been doing and have tried to help out as much as they can. And I can be more thankful to everyone.
You obviously mentioned earlier in the interview that social media plays such a large part of a current fundraising campaign. So how can people keep in touch with what you're doing, Daniel, at the moment?
If they go on to Just Giving, they can search my name, Daniel Selcraig, or the event's name is Sue Rider Skydive 2018. You can track all the progress on there. All my updates are all going onto my Just Giving page. That's where the grand total's at. It's currently at £2,395. Which I still can't believe the amount of support that people have been giving us. But yeah, all my updates are now going on to that one platform there, just so everyone can keep a follow.
And I understand that what you said last time still applies, that none of the money you have received as donations will in fact pay for the skydive. I'm sure that, am I right in thinking that the dive is already paid for?
Yeah,
So every penny that somebody donates will go to the desired target. Is that true?
Yeah, exactly that, Paul. The skydive's already been paid for. All the donations will be going to Sue Ryder at Fort Paul. There's no costs coming out, so to speak.
Fantastic. So obviously you might want to, you've obviously had a lot of help. It might be remiss of me to mention now that in Daniel's day job, not all heroes wear capes, you see. In Daniel's day job, he is actually the groundsman at our local football team, Peterborough United. So how have they been around this event? How much help have you received from them, Daniel?
Yeah, no, they've been first class. Ever since I thought of the idea, all the catering teams have been helping me get money on match days with donation buckets on the bills and that. I've raised hundreds from it, but all the loose change, you know, soon adds up and it has made a big difference to my overall target. But yeah, no, they've been fantastic, really supportive. And actually, this Saturday just gone, it was actually Sue Ryder's fundraising day at Peterborough United, which is brilliant by the football club because it gives charities like that a fantastic platform to raise much-needed funds.
So obviously these events, they don't happen by themselves. How much help have you had in getting towards this event?
Yeah, Sue Ryder themselves have been really supportive with their fundraising team, you know, giving me some ideas and just being really supportive. I know a couple of people that have done skydives. People have, you know, it's been offering advice and support. And yeah, day by day as the event gets closer, I'm starting to get a little bit more nervous. But yeah, really looking forward to the experience.
So am I right in thinking that you've never done a skydive before?
No, I've been on a plane, you know, on holiday, but never decided to jump out of one.
Yeah, I was about to say, I think that's two different things, mate. Yeah, but yeah, fair play. So, would it be fair to say then that you are nervous?
Yeah, oh, definitely, yeah, very nervous. I mean, even just thinking about it now, you know, my belly's going a little bit. I'm nervous. Like, I wouldn't have done it if I wasn't going to get anything from it. Do you know what I mean? Like, I do like to live life to the full and experience as much as I can. So, really looking forward to it, but quite nervous at the same time.
And we best talk about the event in itself then. I'm assuming people can go and watch this. So we've already established it's Monday Bank Holiday. When and where is it, mate? Is it at, etc.?
So it's UK Parachuting, which is based at Stimpson Airfield. It's the morning jump. We've still not been given a time yet, but I'd imagine it will sort of be between 9:30, 10 o'clock time. I've got absolutely hundreds of people coming. Randomers I don't even know, friends, family, Peter United supporters, you name it, people are turning up in their droves. So bring your barbecues, bring your deck chairs, we're gonna have a good time. It's not just me gonna jump and that'll be it. It's gonna have some food and drinks, you know, make a day of it.
Yeah, I can tell you're excited, mate. I can tell you're excited. You're really looking forward to this, aren't you?
Yeah, I mean, it's been such a long time since I've thought of the idea. I deliberately did it so I could try and raise as much money as possible. It really doesn't seem like yesterday since I came up with the idea, but really looking forward to it now. As I said, only a week away. Just get me on that plane.
Fantastic. Do you know anything about the jump? How high will it be actually be when you jump out? Do you know things like that yet?
It's going to be 13,000 feet. It'll take about 15 minutes to cruise up to that height. And then obviously you're free falling for about 45 seconds from about a 3 minute parachute descent. So it's quite a while actually whilst you're up there. Like, it's not quickly fly up and jump out and you're on the ground. You know? I'm expecting it to last a good 15, 20 minutes, so to speak. So I honestly can't wait now. I really can't wait.
Jolly good. Fantastic. So obviously you've had massive support with the club, people closest to you. I mean, how much support actually have you had for this? Have you felt as though, you know, these events, they're very hard to organise, aren't they? And you're working as well. I mean, who has been there for you when you've been struggling the most?
Yeah, obviously my girlfriend and all my family have been really supportive. And, my nan especially. I want to shout out to my nan. Been brilliant. She's been asking a lot of all her dancing friends for donations and stuff, and my nan's just got me over £150 just by herself, bless her. So, yeah, big shout out to my nan, Sheila. Love her lots. And, yeah, I don't know where I'd be without her. Absolutely love her.
Fantastic. So, I'm assuming is she going to watch the event?
Yeah, she'll be there. She seems more nervous about it than I am. Obviously, mum's pretty worried, but, you know, I knew the risks involved before I decided to make the decision. I just wanted to get some money back, Fantastic Planet, and I thought this would probably be the best way of getting money off of people.
Well, yeah, I mean, it sounds like it's going to be a brilliant day all round, food, it's a bit like an event. How many people are jumping on the day then?
I've not got an exact figure. It's a bank holiday. It says on their website to expect up to 100 jumpers. So, there'll be quite a few other planes taking off with people jumping. Obviously, it's not just going to be me. There'll be quite a few others as well.
Okay, brilliant. What we'd like to do, Daniel, as you would know from the first interview we did, is in between the interview, we're just going to be back in a minute for a bit more of, we're going to talk about Daniel's day job a bit for a couple of seconds. And then he'll be able to tell us all how we can still donate, because this campaign is still live at the minute, isn't it, Daniel?
Yeah, it's still there. People can log on.
Okay, so we will learn about how people can donate and keep in touch through the final week as the campaign really gathers momentum. But first, Daniel, have you got a quick song you'd like to hear to break up the interview?
Yeah, why not? Could we have some Be Young, Jumanji, please? Absolute tune at the minute.
Okay, yes, I'll try and find that for you, Daniel. In the meantime, here's Be Young, and we'll be back shortly.
I'm testing. Ring ring pon the hands free. 15 cool the shanty. I sing sing like the Grand Prix. She fling fling off the panties. Oh, and them things extra fancy. She know just what she came to do. She wanna live life Jumanji. Girl, you know I got just the place for you. Oh, we can kick it for the night. Do a little something with the vibe. Put in work for me, don't be shy now. Come on, yourself a couple stripes, girl. Are you keeping me guessing? Yeah, I swear your body a blessing. Yeah, big body girl, you got my attention. Whoa, I put that body through some testing. Ring ring pon the hands free. 15 cool the shanty. I sing sing like the Grand Prix. She fling fling off the panties. Oh, and them things extra fancy. She know just what she came to do. She wanna live life Jumanji. Girl, you know I got just the place for you. So let me bring down the lighting. Slip off your tights and we can be vibing. Girl, I see you lip biting. You got the cake and I got the icing. Now I got you igniting. Grinding and hitting the spots that you liking. I swear that big batty frightening. Why do you swapping your main with your sighting? Ring ring pon the hands free. 15 cool the shanty. I sing sing like the Grand Prix. She fling fling off the panties. Oh, and them things extra fancy. She know just what she came to do. She wanna live life Jumanji. Girl, you know I got just the place for you.
Hello, welcome back everybody to Reprieve Media CIC. That was Be Young there as requested by Daniel Selcraig. So we're just going to wrap up the interview now with a bit. I just want to touch on a specific thing that happened to you. What month was it now? when Peterborough United played at home to Walsall?
Yeah, it was a game against Walsall in League One. It was a cold Tuesday night. It was quite a while ago now. It was must be back in February.
That was really what I would consider to be, hell, it never won an award. It was a superhuman event, really, to get that game on. And there was time for a good day or two there where you were arguably the most famous man in this town, I'd say. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, it was, especially when I got home and looked at my phone, we had over a million views on Twitter of us wearing snow with Steve, the posh centre-back, who kindly grabbed the shovel halfway through help us clear the pitch of the snow and got the lines clear for the referee.
That man should get a testimonial already down here.
Absolute
legend of a bloke.
Yeah, he's brilliant. And I got home and my phone was going absolutely nuts. Loads of tweets and messages from fans, saying well done. But I've just got to be quite clear on this. I'm fortunate to be the stadium head groundsman, but I'm also backed up by a fantastic team of volunteers who come in every match day. The atmosphere is first class. I love the club. They're supporters of the club. And without the lads behind me, my job would be really difficult.
That's very true. That's very true. And I noticed that you were even that complimentary about them on other outlets as well. So modesty as well, But what a fantastic job. And the exposure for yourself and the exposure for the club around that managed to just coincide with this event. It's strange how things come together when you do the right thing, isn't it?
Yeah, it was absolutely brilliant. And I'd just like to quickly say a massive thank you to the Peterborough United chairman, Darren McAnthony, who actually sponsored me £800 towards my skydive fundraising as a thank you for getting that game on. So I was always going to do my best to get the game on, but for him to show so much appreciation and donate such a large amount of money was absolutely, I was gobsmacked. And I really appreciate it. So a big thank you to him if he does listen to this.
So are you back to normal now then? Have you had to sack your agent yet?
we're all good now.
So obviously you said, that was in extreme circumstances really. Have you ever come across that situation or anything like that before in your time as a groundsman?
Not really. The weather this season has just been absolutely ridiculous. We've not seen rain like it for years. Obviously, we had snow February and March. It's very, very rare to be able to get a game on in those sort of conditions. Just to give people who weren't there an understanding, about 7:15, there was absolutely no snow on the pitch. By 8:15, we had it 0.5 foot. The pitch, I won't go on and on about it, but the pitch wasn't frozen because of the work we did beforehand. So the snow insulated the pitch to stop it from freezing. To be able to just keep the game on and keep the referee happy with the surface and keeping all the lines clean was just a massive team effort. We had everyone out there from...
Literally. It was literally a team effort because like Daniel said, you had members of the team stopping the game when the game was out, people getting treatment or throwing. They were cleaning the pitch themselves, weren't they?
Yeah, I was cleaning the London Road area, and next thing I know, Stephen Taylor's ran up to me, physically grabbed the brush off of me, and started doing the rest of the line for me, so I could do another part of the pitch. It's remarkable, you wouldn't see anything like that again. You would from Stephen Taylor, because that's the sort of professional he is, he's top class. But those games in the Championship that were called off that night, with under 30 in, have that luxury. It just shows you how much hard work and dedication of the whole team, the whole staff of Peter United to get a game on was fantastic.
Yeah, it was. And all credit to you and your team from me. I know from first hand, I've been to a few games in back in the day, and that pitch would have resembled the Somme if it had had the weather it had this year, 20 years ago on it. I know that for a fact. And I think the club would know that as well. And you touched on all the investment as well, that obviously helped, didn't it, in the lead up to the day?
Yeah, on a good football pitch, it does cost a lot of money, unfortunately, and the club has certainly done the right thing to can't touch on too much for next season, but yeah, there'll be huge improvements again over the summer. And I think some fans will get a shock when they come back for the pre-season from Leeds, because I don't want to go on to too much detail, but yeah, big changes.
Fantastic. So thank you for joining us, Daniel. We know how busy you are. So before we wrap this up, can you just tell people how they can still donate to your skydive, which is happening a week today?
Yeah, so people can go online, www.justgiving.com/SueRyderSkydive2018, or just go on to justgiving.com and type in my name. It's Daniel Selcraig. That's Selcraig. That's where all the donations are going to. And yeah, I'd really appreciate it. A week to go. I'd be absolutely thrilled if we could get to £3,000. A big ask. I know that's a big ask with how the times are, and you know, people are struggling. But if you know, if you've just been paid and you have got some spare cash, I'd really appreciate it. And so would the hospice. They rely solely on funding to stay open. They do an absolutely marvellous job up at Fort Hall. And yeah, I'd be ever so grateful if anyone would donate. It means so much to me, and especially my family as well.
Fantastic. And obviously people would like to keep up with the progress on social media. How can they find you on social media and keep up with events both at the club and regarding the skydive?
So yeah, obviously full Posh News, go on to www.theposh.com. We'll follow them at the Posh Official on Twitter. If you want to follow my fundraising campaign, you can follow my Facebook page. It's at Daniel Selcraig, the same on Instagram. And also my Just Giving page is primarily where most of the updates are going. So there'll be footage released on the skydive as well, that's being filmed for me. I believe BBC Look East are coming down as well. So it might even make some local news as well, which would be fantastic. But this isn't about me. This is trying to make as much money for New Rider as possible. So, if people can donate, I'd be thrilled.
Okay, fantastic. And the time again, quickly, in the date before we go, please.
Yeah, so it is Monday, the 7th of May. We're looking at quite an early jump between 9 and 10 o'clock at Sibson Airfield. It's all to raise money for Sue Hall.
Fantastic. Daniel, may I take this opportunity to wish you good luck personally?
Thank you so much, Paul. Thank you once again for having us on.
Anytime, sir, anytime. And good luck with the event. Daniel Selcraig, thank you very much for allowing us to interview you, and good luck for the event, sir.
Thank you very much, Paul. Cheers. Good night.